ALLEXCEPT belongs to the all family of functions in DAX. As such, it has two different usages. It can be used as a table function or as a calculate modifier. When used as a table function, ALLEXCEPT behaves much like all with a table, with the difference that ALLEXCEPT can let you ignore some of the columns. Let's see some examples. In this first example, I'm using ALLEXCEPT product, so all product except the product key and the product code. The result contains all the columns of the product table, the name, the manufacturer, the brand, but it is missing both the product key and the product code. Product key and product code belong to the product table, and we can see if we look at the result of the second evaluator that retrieves all the product. And among the many columns, we have the product key and the product code, which are missing in the first row, in the first result. Now, keep in mind that when you remove columns from a table, you might actually remove also rows, because ALLEXCEPT performs a distinct over the result, so it removes duplicates. In this example, I'm removing out of the product table all the columns. The only one remaining is the product color, and the result includes only the 16 colors that are available in our database. By removing columns, I'm actually removing also rows from the result. Now, the most common usage of ALLEXCEPT is to use it as a calculate modifier. When used as a calculate modifier, ALLEXCEPT removes filters from the table and never adds filter. This is important because it is a modifier and no longer a table function. Let's look at first simple example. We are using an outer calculate table where we place a filter on the brand and the filter on the color. The brand needs to be Contoso and the color needs to be red. In the inner calculate table, we evaluate product, modifying the filter context through ALLEXCEPT that does all on all the columns of the product table except the brand. Because it removes all the filter from product except the brand, it will kill the filter on the color and keep the filter on the brand. As you see in the result, we have the brand, which is always Contoso, whereas the color can be white or gray. So the filter on the color is gone, the filter on the brand is kept. An important detail about ALLEXCEPT is that ALLEXCEPT works on the expanded table when you use it as a calculate modifier. Therefore, you can use as except columns not only columns of the base table, but also columns of the expanded table. Not only that, you can also remove entire tables. Let's see that with an example. I have four calculations here: a measure sales that just counts the number of sales, and then the outer calculate table places a filter on the color, red, and a filter on calendar year, 2009. The first calculation is just number of sales, so these are the sales in the current filter context, meaning 2009 red. The second calculate does ALLEXCEPT sales date, so it removes any filter from the sales table, keeping only the filters on the date. That is why the filter on the year is kept and the filter on the color is removed. Please note that we are using the full date table. So from the expanded set table sales, we are removing the expanded table date. In the next calculation, we are doing a similar operation, but this time with one column only and with the product color. Because we had a filter on the product color, which is kept, and we had a filter on the year, which is removed, the expanded table sales, so ALLEXCEPT on the expanded table sales, removes the filter from the date, therefore the year, but keeps the filter on the product color. If you want the number of total sales, you just use remove filters to get rid of any filter, and the numbers, of course, are all different one by the other. Keep in mind that the full number of sales, 100,231, because this number is going to be useful in the next calculation. A very common mistake for newbies is to mismatch the usage of ALLEXCEPT as a table function with the usage as a calculate modifier. Its behavior is very different. Look at this example. The first calculation does calculate count row sales ALLEXCEPT sales date. ALLEXCEPT is used as a calculate modifier. In the second calculation, I'm doing count rows all except sales date. So I'm using all except as a table function. The first result does calculate count row sales all except sales date. So it's getting rid of any filter except the filter on the date. On the date, we have a filter on 2009, which is kept because all except explicitly says that we do want to keep filters on the date. So the result is 39,000 that are the sales in 2009. When we use it as a table function, count rows all except sales date does not remove a filter. Instead, it returns all the rows of the expanded sales table except the rows which are present in date. And as any all function, it ignores the filter context. Therefore, the result contains the entire sales table. And it returns 100,231 rows, which is the total number of rows which are present in the sales table.